Hello! Shoyan here. I'm a carpenter based in Japan. Building is all about level. These days, we can project a true horizontal beam with a flick of a switch using this laser level. But what about the time before laser levels were invented? I'd like to talk about that. In today's age of laser levels, you simply flick a switch to project a 360 degrees true horizontal line. Before lasers were invented, carpenters used a surveying instrument. It is called a level and is used for level reference. They are still available. The laser level is very useful, but it's difficult to see the laser line outside when it's sunny. So we use a laser level inside the building from a 10 meters distance, and we use this level outside. Since two people used to be required to operate the level, the laser type auto level was developed. So both are currently used today, but the level is older. Before these instruments were developed, we used this leveling device. It is called water level, Mizumorikan in Japanese. The can will be filled with water, and a clear tube is used to check the water level. It's an old leveling device that can give a level, providing you don't add or drain water. This device was used to level both inside and outside. It's difficult to imagine how to use it, so let's try it out. This is a water level can. It's a cylindrical shape. Set this tube under the can. Fill it with water, like this. Since its name is a water level, water is necessary. Honestly, it's a hassle to prepare this device. It won't be accurate even if a small amount of air gets into the water. It takes a lot of preparation to use this water level. It may be difficult to see because of deterioration, but here's the water line. If I raise it, the level will drop. If I lower it, the level will rise. If you want to stop it moving, plug up the end with a finger. It reminds me of the old days. Plug and open the finger like this. Then use the water level as a reference and mark there. The water line is the same height as the water in the can. Due to surface tension, it is rising. Mark the highest position if you decide to do so. The disadvantage of this laser level is that it won't work if there are obstacles in between. A room next door will not be lit. By contrast, this water level can be used at a distance, so it can level despite obstacles. For example, in the room next door and outside, too. Up to about 40 years ago, people used water levels like this for leveling. Here's an extra bit of information. What about the times when there were no clear tubes and water levels? For example, in the Edo period. This is a paper box. People made a long box like this. They filled it with water and measured the height from the surface of the water. It's not only the box. A bamboo can also be used if it is cut in half and both ends are closed to fill water. Even if the bamboo is curved or the box is tilted, the water inside can be used as a level reference when it has become calm. In Japanese, level is written as water and flat. People measured the level from filled flat water. I think the word's origin is from there. The famous pyramid, built 4,500 years ago, was measured at four corners, and the level didn't differ by a centimeter. Today, we can get a level just by flicking a switch. But I can imagine that old people would have worked very hard to make a building level. That's all about how levels were determined in the old days. Thanks for watching!